Today I'm talking about exploratory spatial data analysis. To start, let's talk about exploratory data analysis. I'm sure most of you are familiar with it, but good to recap. So exploratory data analysis, or EDA, is an approach slash philosophy for data analysis that employs a variety of techniques, mostly graphical, to one, maximize insight into a data set, cover underlying structure, extract variables, detect outliers and anomalies. So one paper, for example, described EDA as the intent to discover potentially explicable patterns. So EDA, as we might know, has an emphasis on data visualization, a use of descriptive statistics, and it really emphasizes on discovering outliers in your data set. So here are two wonderful graphics from the Tidy Tuesday. This is how I'm guessing most of us are familiar with EDA itself. So exploratory spatial data analysis takes these takes the same concepts and applies it to spatial data. So to understand that, we have to start with the first law of geography, which states that everything is related to everything else, but near things are more related than distant things. So in essence, ESDA extends exploratory data analysis to spatial relationships. It asks questions like, are things randomly distributed in space? Are there spatial outliers? Are close things more similar than things that are further away? So where EDA compares a part to the whole, ESDA compares a part to its neighboring parts. So in ESDA, or exploratory spatial data analysis, we evaluate a location relative to its neighboring location, not the whole or group, right? So I learned exploratory spatial data analysis in grad school, and I learned it through Python and libraries like GeoPandas, Shapely, and pysal. But it was Python, and I really wanted to use RStats. So around 2021, I wanted to get back into this, and I discovered the R package sfdep. So it's a package for spatial dependence, weighting, and statistics. So some things about sfdep. It was first released in 2002, and it was initially designed for SP objects, which is like the first way to interact with spatial data in R, and I'm not sure if any of you have used it. Interesting. And it covers most of the spatial econometrics, so statistics, weights, neighbors, and things like that. But in 2002, I was six, and I essentially grew up with the tidyverse. So when I use sfdep, I have this a little bit of like a perceived paradigm gap, where the way that sfdep functions is different than the way I think about R. So naturally, when I couldn't make a neighbor list in a mutate function call, I created an issue. And unfortunately, that issue went nowhere. So my response was to create a tidy interface called sfdep. So sfdep is an interface, an extension to spdep for spatial dependent. And some principles are that I always want to use sf objects for geometry. That's what I'm familiar with, and most people might be. Always return dplyr-friendly objects, so lists, data frames, vectors. And then additionally, functionality shouldn't be dependent upon dplyr for those who don't want dplyr. And then additionally, all functionality that I've additional functionality is implemented using sfdep objects for like backwards compatibility. And then, so fundamentally, with exploratory spatial data analysis, we need to understand our neighbor. And to do that, we'll use the st contiguity function, which takes an sfc class object, or the geometry column of an sf object, and returns a list for identifying your neighbors. Here's an example of that using dplyr friendly code. And the result is a list with where each element is an integer vector, and the elements contain row positions of its neighbors. And we're not just limited to identifying contiguity for polygons. We can implement finding k-nearest neighbors, distance bands, so on and so forth. And additionally, if you want to use spatial weights, we just pass in the neighbor object, the spatial weights, and we get row standardized by default. So here's an example of doing all that in one call with mutate. Again, we're not just limited to that. So let's compare the syntax. So here's a map of comparing clusters of crime in 1830s France. Here's the code for using sfdep. It was no pipe operator and lots of assignments. Here's the same result using sfdep, one assignment and two pipe operators. So here's the same map, same different code, same results. So sfdep doesn't just act as an interface, it extends it as well. So we can do local join counts, the first open source implementation of co-location quotients, and also implements Esri's emerging hotspot analysis. It also integrates with SF networks. So what's next? User validation, ensure parity with Python, and then make a hex logo one day. So give it a star and give it a go. Thanks.